Hey, 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 everybody. It's the Mean Boys Podcast with Dave Ross, one of our favorites.
Man, the banana master himself.
Master.
The Bandam Academy comes back to the show. Dave Ross himself.
Everybody knows Dave loves bandanas, all right?
Dave loves that shit. That's why he joined the Crips and the Bloods. He's the only white guy with dual membership.
No, he has just a purple bandana, and everyone's like, I have no clue what to make of this.
God, that fucker reps the Grimace hard, B.
Dave's an amazing comedian. You got to go to his album taping coming up at the Satellite in Los Angeles. Ticket information for that will be in the show notes if you're in the area and you want to come out. And he came on to promote Hampton Young's album, which should be coming out soon, because Hampton doesn't check his Facebook messages. So if you'd like to have Hampton on the show, us too, send him a tweet.
Yeah, please harass him.
That came out bitterer than I wanted it to.
No, we love Hampton.
He's great. He riffs like the Harlem Globetrotters play basketball. He's unstoppable.
Yeah, I've never seen somebody so confidently dunk on Connor, who I believe to be one of the fastest men alive.
I know, it's humiliating. I feel like Han Solo when that Dash Rendar guy shows up in Shadows of the Empire. That's a joke for my high school friends.
Dave's also great, and he was on this episode. And
he's not only is he beautiful, but he's funny too.
Yeah,
yeah.
But so, Dave is present.
Yeah,
so, you know.
Dave's here. Go listen to Suicide Buddies, our label mates over on Star Runs Audio. That's also in the show notes, and that's a great podcast. I've listened to it. I fucking dig it. Those guys are. If you don't want to hear those two guys talk about suicide, what the hell's the matter with you?
Yeah.
Man, fucking something. And back to some exciting news in Mean Boys world. The tour is being locked in, and we're ready to announce cities.
Woo.
And we're fucking stoked. We're gonna be going out on more of these, more like little short 10-14 day jaunts instead of a 30 day weird like Colonel Kurtz descent into not having laundry.
Yeah, that last big one was like super fun, but it also almost killed all of us.
Yeah, so we're gonna have some fun breezy little getaways throughout the year. And so if your city's not here, still fill out that tour sheet if you want us to come do a show near you and come check us out. And make sure you're on the email list, because we will be tweeting out some cheaper tickets to email list subscribers for a little bit, so you get the jump.
Yes.
You get the jump on the rest of the plebs.
But this tour, late March, early April, we're going to Houston.
Whoa.
We're going to Austin.
Shit.
We're going to Dallas.
Well, that's also in Texas.
We're going to Kansas City.
That's not in Texas.
We're down.
We're going to St. Louis.
Shazam.
We're going to motherfucking Nashville.
Whoa.
North. Hotlanta.
Coldlanta.
And of course, the Mean Boys capital of the world, goddamn Florida.
Yeah,
these
finally.
Buffoons are going to the lagoon. We'll see you in Orlando, fucknuts.
I haven't
Dude,
been.
They have
I'm
Disney
so
stuff there.
Wow, our favorite. Why would you bring that up?
We love that shit. But those are the cities we're hitting on this tour. We are really excited to go. We'll be announcing ticket links and venues and all that shit as it's locked in. Some of it's already locked. A few things we're waiting to finalize right now.
Yeah, just one more thing. Please come.
Yeah, please come. When
please.
We put the tickets up, please buy them, because money does help us book travel for these.
Yeah, things. Again, it's. I know the show is. Look, we get some cool people on, and we're doing okay on the Patreon. Remember that this is three guys that live in a house that's always on fire. And we're being gentrified out of our neighborhood. I know that, because as I pulled in today, I saw a guy in a black hoodie smoking a Pall Mall, walking two Chihuahuas. The end is near. Mm. And speaking of. Giving us money, we got some like 10 meanies left in stock. They're black, and I got like one of the color. I'll tweet out the link tomorrow so you guys can cop those. But get yourself a meanie if you haven't got one already. They're people dig them.
They're great.
I like seeing the pictures.
They're
cool.
Awesome. And that made us stoked.
We got
too,
a picture today from friendly Keith Ray. Bought a beanie. Keith Ray. So it works for him. It'll work for you.
Yeah, and we're glad you guys are stoked on that. We're probably going to be making more wacky apparel items. In the very near.
You have no idea how much I've enjoyed becoming a fashion icon within the cigarette bumming community.
Yeah,
here.
I'd like for us to be a bad podcast, but a pretty good T-shirt company.
Yeah,
like I want us to be one of those T-shirt companies that's just always at Ross and you never see them anywhere else.
Oh fuck yeah!
I want to be like paper, denim, and cloth.
Yes. Oh yes. Dude, that was such a specific man. If I wasn't fucking exhausted, I could think of a few. But yeah, Brixton Academy.
Oh shit!
A lot of
dog.
Brixton Academy jackets.
Oh, Platinum 88.
Yeah. Oh shit.
I know none of these things.
A lot of weird ones that just say various versions of California with some sort of skull or
star. Yeah, and then one
star
Deadpool
or
shirt
rose.
Mixed in for some reason.
Oh, there's always one.
God, Ross is garbage.
But it's like the Deadpool like crossover, but with the off-brand. It's like, oh, Easter Deadpool. I guess that would be a Ross.
Yeah.
I've never been to a Ross. I did help two people get married at a Sears.
Anyway.
What?
Well, I introduced
them.
That's
not a service they offer.
That doesn't count as helping if you just introduce them, Tom.
I introduced. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I guess you did. All right, I'll give it to you. It's a weird technicality. You picked the strangest way to phrase that, but it's still technically true.
I'm sorry I didn't phrase it for your liking.
I liked it. I phrase
how I be.
You'd stop cantankering over there, you son of a bitch.
Anyway, buy a Manny. if you don't have any money, that's fine. Here are things you can do to help us keep being fucking morons.
Get a job and send us some money.
Yeah, send us a greasy envelope full of loose cash you stole from your mom.
Shell it out, pay pigs.
Leave us a goddamn iTunes review. We are trying to get to 500. If we get to 500 iTunes reviews, Tom Goss will be tased.
And if you don't want to see Tom...
More stun guns. It's a stun gun,
If you don't want to see video footage of Tom Goss being tased in Orlando, unsubscribe.
That's the thing. We're going on tour last week of March, first week of April. We got to get to 500 by then so we can tase Tom.
There's nothing but static electricity in the air. It's all humidity and fat and sweat.
Here's my dream version.
We're going to be eating skateboard-sized grilled cheeses again.
We're about to tase Tom. Right as that happens, a rogue alligator runs into the room. They both get tased at the same time, and now we got a Brundle Gator, baby.
What?
Who's Brundle Gator?
It's going to be you.
She's the longest-serving justice.
Ruth Brundle Gator.
Best intro ever.
And the dissenting opinion on Roe v. Wade. Supreme Court Justice
Roe
Gator.
Roe v. Waiters.
Declaring simply, chickens be delicious.
Chickens be delicious was a he met with Teddy Roosevelt about civil rights. Oh, fuck. I forgot about the whole chicken and black people thing, so that came out racist.
You're fine.
I was trying to do a B middle initial joke.
Anyway,
so fucking Dave writes, 5 stars. It's fine. Tase Tom, quote, attributed to Fred Durst. So I don't know really what's going on there, but I like it.
A lot to unpack. I like it. Wait. Fred Durst listens to our show and is invested enough to leave a review.
I bet we have one person that we would find famous that listens that we're unaware. I bet we'd find out, like, some guy that was in CKY listens or something.
Oh,
that
would be so cool.
Or some sort of like I don't know, maybe like one of the Circle Jerks touring members or something.
Yeah, I'm into that.
Yeah.
What did he write about Fred Durst?
He said it's okay to tase you. It's fine, tase Tom.
Oh, said Fred Durst.
Yeah, which I don't know where Fred begins or ends in this equation, but whatever. He's
quote the Fred Durst. Quote
the fucking rap rock raven.
Yeah, what is he, Limp Bizkit? Who is he again?
He's the Limp Bizkit guy.
Yeah.
I want to start a Limp Bizkit cover band called Hard Tech. And we play it like jazz. All right. Hey, man, we got a Reddit page. We just broke 500 subscribers, which is only halfway away from not looking embarrassingly bad.
jump on the Reddit. Jump on our Discord server.
Our Mean Boys. Yeah, the Discord server. The link for that's in the show notes. The Discord server is a lot of fun. It's a chat room. It's popping off in there. People are just talking about, I don't know, Mean Boys-y shit. It's great.
Really, what's fun about the Discord server is that it has stopped being really related. I'll go in periodically and just look for Mean Boys talk.
Yeah.
There's very little of it.
Now they're just talking about, like, recipes.
There's a whole recipe board. There's just, like, conversation about their day. There was a video of somebody putting a butt plug in earlier, which was pretty cool.
Oh, nice.
You showed me a few Mean Boys fans that are remain nameless as penises, and oh my God, I didn't need to see that. It's really weird.
We have a fan base with some daunting cocks. I'm really proud of you guys.
It was upsettingly robust.
That's the thing. I've never seen a bad dick on a Mean Boys fan.
Yeah.
You guys rule.
Anyway, go check those out. Patreon, $5 a month, weekly bonus content.
Yeah.
We just had a really fun show with Robbie Goodman. You'll hear a clip from that later. We're talking Family Guy voices. We're talking CISO talk. We're talking good stuff, guys.
Man, come join us at the bottom of the barrel.
Yeah, we've retooled those. We got guests in now. It's a lot of fun. We're riffing, shooting the shit. It's a fast-paced, high-energy time. And $10 a month, that's a monthly goodie. Tom, what are we doing this month?
If you love Cone Zone, and you love keys, and you love chains...
And you love not losing things, which is probably an issue for you if you think it's a good idea to invest in Cone Zone.
If you love all those three things together, we have a hat... No, I'm kidding. We have a Cone Zone keychain.
Hell yeah.
That you can fucking, put on your key, or your toe, or
And here's what's great about...
Your toe ring keychain.
Here's what's great about this. Is the Cone Zone keychain, people are going to see that and be like, what is the Cone Zone? And then you get to do Tom's pitch. Forever. We get to market test this idea in the field. If it works, if you pitch cones on it and people seem excited about it, if we get enough, maybe we start working on making like a miniature version of this.
Yeah, I mean, maybe
no, it's
Halloween,
a full-out
maybe
version.
Maybe by the time we do Halloween this year, we can make it a big party like we wanted to and have a pop-up cone
oh
zone.
Oh, my God,
truck.
A pop-up cone zone truck!
Keith, that was the gayest thing I've seen in my entire
Dude,
life.
I got so excited. That's such a great idea.
Yeah.
You did the thing where you're getting ready to like fist bump the air like at the end of that 180s movie yes. with pussy,
yes.
but you didn't do it all. You just shook your body
Don't
instead.
Forget about cold.
Yeah, instead of raising it, you just shook your. You all did right, the
well,
wiggle.
I supported this dumb idea for the first time ever, and you're mocking me.
Yeah, so, you stupid asshole.
Whatever, you hard vanilla yeah, dunce.
You shimmied with unbridled. Joy.
It was that was
motherfucking feel.
That was the cutest thing I've ever seen.
It was adorable. You look
like if a dog did that on video, it would go viral in 3 seconds.
Oh, it would go viral after it gets fucked. You guys heard the one about Keith and the
Ayo.
Dog? Yeah. So fucking check out the Patreon. Help support a small business. It's National Small Business Month
yeah.
here at LegalZoom.
Is it?
No, I just fucking hate LegalZoom's ads where yeah. they pretend it's National Small Business Month
Man,
every goddamn
would be funnier
month.
Than if we got sponsored by LegalZoom.
Oh, I think we
I
shot
think
that in
service.
The dick.
You know, I'm sure yeah. they have great deals. Are you listening?
Zoom your legals?
No, I hope Jason, our boss, isn't listening to this part. So that's going on. Fucking follow us on all the socials. Get a little more Mean Boys in your life every day. We just did a pretty good video of me and Tom singing. We're just two bros singing Pixies songs at 1 in the morning.
Oh yeah. It was pretty. It was exactly what people. Imagine
not even
doing.
Ironically, both very
oh,
into
no.
it.
Super into it.
Yeah.
And there was that one moment where we both sang the note, the wrong pitch. And yeah. go, oh, that was supposed to be later in the song. And yes. then pretended to not feel like dorks.
Yeah. And then we watched a lot more Pixies clips.
Yeah.
But anyway, it's time to get into the show. Dave Ross is our guest. It's going to be an all-timer. You know that. Here it is.
Dave's an all-time favorite.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Mean Boys Podcast. The world's a motorcycle gang and you're the fat guy in the trike. I'm Connor McSpadden.
I'm Dave Ross.
I'm Keith Carey.
And I am...
A coach for professional eaters. Whenever I see you just chain smoking and just eating fistfuls of loose nuts in the tap out shorts, it's all I can think.
Yeah,
it doesn't
yeah.
help that you play the Rocky theme while you're snacking. Yeah. I never understood why that was your snacking music.
Gonna fly now.
Yeah, there's no less Don't. Trustworthy guy than the guy who wears workout clothes and is not working out.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a real recipe for bad stepdad kind of, you know.
Yeah.
Like the tracksuit really is the stepdad tuxedo, you know? Cuz I've never seen anybody that owns a tracksuit break a sweat, yet that's ostensibly what the garment is for.
Yeah, well I have a track jacket that I wear sometimes and I feel like people look at me and they're like he sells ladies. Like that's the only thing.
That guy has a shipping container full of bulk holes.
Yeah, he sells a crate of discount women.
Dude, I've been in the market for a tracksuit for a little while. And I'm trying it's an investment and I'm trying to shop around
you
and
know,
find the right
one. That about you, actually.
And I was going on OfferUp, and I said, wait a minute, Connor. You're currently seriously considering buying a used tracksuit.
Oh,
arguably
no.
the worst thing on the earth to buy pre-owned. Car, wife, anything better than tracksuit.
Well, yeah, because it's either full of ball sweat or, like, Russian mob blood. Like, it's the only
Absolutely.
Two options.
Absolutely.
I would rather buy a used condom than a used tracksuit.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, that sounds fucking...
By the way, I do like that this podcast is make Dave come over while he's sick and then riff without letting him speak. Real hospitality here.
Well, in fairness, that's most comedy podcasts. Have you ever done one?
yeah, watch
Damn,
us talk
really
to each
coming
other.
At you. Have you ever done mine? It's just like, you should be a guest on our show. Just sit here and... Make our numbers go up.
Yeah, and try to get a word in edgewise while Hampton does a one-man show about some sort of circus bear that's getting a divorce that he just came up with.
Hey, he's doing Mean Boys soon, huh?
Oh, you know what's funny? We're like...
because he won't respond to texts.
No, oh, no.
He was supposed to come today.
Dave is I know that all too well.
Dave is here to promote Hampton's album because we saw, oh, Hampton's having an album out. I wonder if he'd like to come do Mean Boys. And then we're like, well, yeah, we can get him on with Dave. It'll be a super episode. And long story short, I think Hampton's dead and what's up, Dave.
Anyway, you should buy Hampton's album, Abel.
Yeah.
If he's dead, I'm taking that money.
Oh, hell yeah, dude.
Fuck yeah.
You're just shirt. Writing a clearly fake will on the back of like a kid's menu from Burger King.
Is there
yeah, I had the worst plan of all time. I wanted to get all the money from Hampton's new album after he kills himself.
Is there a worse thing to be left in a will than Spotify streaming revenue? Like, that's like, oh, just give me the cat.
Yeah, my friend is dead, but I'll make 78.
I can opt that. One of the times I tried to kill myself, I left my phone to my little brother, and it was not a good phone.
Oh my god, you left him an LG, it was 1405.
The flip phone goes to Shun. It was so fucking.
He's like, well, my brother's dead, but I can play Snake now, so that's a good setup.
The loose change goes to Larissa.
Wait, you spell RIP and T9?
You were going to kill yourself, and you were like, well, I gotta tie up some loose ends.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I want to make sure my Tamagotchis have a good home.
Totally.
I love the idea of you just giving out every individual thing you. My left shoe goes to my mom. My right shoe goes to the mailman. You guys sort it out.
Yeah. Oh, I did, and there was so little, but I was like, I need to leave them something so they know I'm not upset with them in any way.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll really soothe the pain.
Yeah. This is like
wow.
The dumbest. This is something
and
I wrote.
My hockey stick tape goes to Connor.
I wrote this in Spanish class.
And the bullet in my head goes to...
Opens envelope. Oh, moonlight. Oh, my God. No way. Again, congrats, guys. You really earned it.
One of the other things I put in there is no one gets the computer.
What, you're going to be buried with it like a shitty pharaoh?
Yeah, oh, no, I was just like, I don't want anyone to see
it. I want to cremate the porn into my soul an Egyptian king, you know?
I also refuse to believe you had a computer.
Yeah. I barely have one now.
I worked too hard collecting all these 1080p Aspirate files. I want them in the other dimension.
Tom didn't have a computer. He had an Etch-a-Sketch and supportive parents. That's
what he had. No, he had an empty Domino's box and an Adderall problem. Is what he had.
They're like, what are you drawing on the internet?
Yes.
That's my favorite bit of all time is every time Keith is sitting in front of an open pizza box, I say, oh, Keith's working on his laptop.
Oh, that's amazing.
The worst part of that is that there's been enough times that you can say the phrase every time he's sitting in front of an empty pizza box.
It's so good, dude. Oh, my God.
Just staring into the nothingness in the middle of the pizza box.
Yeah, looking at like the grease spot shaped like where my joy used to be.
Absolutely.
The little white picnic table is like the Mac loading wheel, you know, on the pizza laptop.
Being like, I'm not going to eat the cheese baked into the corner and then be like, yeah, I am. Yeah.
You're resting. Yeah. You have like that mouse rest hand thing, but it's breadsticks.
I have like a supportive mouse pad.
Yeah.
It comes with 1 year free of Papa McAfee's.
It's breadsticks and just a butter container. Just
yeah. Oh, man. A lot of good pizza laptop stuff.
Dude, I love it. You guys love pizza?
I like pizza.
I kind of don't give a shit about pizza.
Ah, dude, pizza's the best.
I don't believe that.
I'll eat it.
we just built you a pizza computer. What are you talking about?
I've seen you just walk around hauling a pizza under your arm like a construction worker carrying 4x4s.
Well,
you know,
yeah, like, it's because I usually have like my girlfriend's in the basement and I got to feed her something and I don't want
to
go anywhere.
Yeah, my
like,
girlfriend's. I got to go throw a pizza down to my girlfriend in the basement and tell her, you know, the whatever the fucking Buffalo Dan speech is or whatever.
Buffalo Dan?
I don't know. I don't.
This riff got weird.
Yeah, it did.
Like out of nowhere.
Yeah, we got to cannibalism
pizza?
So quickly.
Yeah, absolutely.
Man, everyone, the shittiness of our house is stuff of legend, and it just rained, and shit just works weird in the house when it rains. Like, hey, Keith, can you run the hot water? I'm trying to make some toast. Like, there's like certain like little connections that like, look, unless the light on the kitchen's on, you're not going to be able to get on the internet.
Well,
so.
The rain always makes more knives wash up on Tom's bed.
Yeah. the rain knocks electrical outlets by my bed. None of the electrical outlets work anymore.
Texas, like, are your guys' outlets working? And everyone's like, yeah. And I'm like, oh, I guess it just sucks to be Tom right now.
I did walk
the
by.
The guy who needs outlets the most, probably.
I was walking out of the kitchen the other day while it was raining, and Tom was just sitting on his bed, not really doing anything, but the lights are just flickering because of the rain around him, and you've never looked more terrifying in your life.
Oh, yeah. It's like, I had a bad dream, and now the Wi-Fi's down.
Yeah.
I'm having a bad day. The power went out in the part of the kitchen I sleep in.
Yeah, like, you just looked like the Babadook if he gave up on monster activity and just moved in.
Yeah.
Last time Tom farted, there was a small blackout in the neighborhood. Yeah. So, I mean, I do believe
I felt that one, yeah.
I believe he's
I live in Glendale.
He's like the first generation of those looper, like ESP guys, you know, where he's got the shitty telekinesis.
Yeah, sometimes I worry about that. I know I shouldn't worry about that, but sometimes I genuinely worry about
that. Honestly, you're the one guy who probably should.
Yeah. Remember when the table shook for no reason?
Yes. I will never forget when you got angry and the table shook for no reason. That was one of the most upsetting things I've ever seen.
What?
Me and Tom were outside.
I was so happy that you and Spencer were there for that, because that's one of the things, if I just told you guys that happened, no one would believe me.
So what'd you get mad about?
Yeah, what happened? I wasn't there for this. It wasn't even something dramatic.
It was like Tabasco Tapatio level, like Tom anger. You know, like baseline, like, you know, fucking casual anger.
I think I was bitching about my ex or something.
Maybe,
like,
yeah. It was just sort of a
And then furniture just started
it
trembling.
It just slid.
Yeah, it slid
it
like
just shook
inches.
And slid.
And yeah, it had not moved at all, and there was no breeze, there was no shaking of other objects, just that one table moved.
And we all looked at each other's feet and shared, like, what the fuck was that? Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, that was a pretty good one.
Anyway, they did do experiments on my brain at one point, but I don't think
that
had anything.
Who is they?
Doctors?
I feel like we're really jumping around in this conversation.
This is what we did on our bonus episode.
Yeah, that makes sense. That
Tom Goss is Beach Bum Akira.
I don't know what they did, but they gave me $50 for it.
They did experiments on your brain. Oh, it was like a study that you signed up for.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, they asked
Tom got
me to
an
be
Applebee's
in
gift card
they
one
asked
time
you to
be electrocuted,
in it. Yes.
And now he has powers.
Because of your... They were like... We know that your brain is good for this experiment.
Yes, that's exactly what it was. They're like, ooh, you fit our qualifications. You're here anyway. Would you like
to
make
Connor,
$50?
I'm sorry, man. I really need a lot more detail.
I have one more question on this subject. In what study are you part of any fucking useful control group? You know what I mean?
That's what I'm asking. Like,
yeah.
There's no more of that.
Because what you just said was, not only was your brain useful for this study, they had heard tell of your brain before, and they were like, well, we got to get him. How do we get a brain this angry and able to move tables? There is a man in Los Angeles County who lives such a destitute existence that when he gets angry... plywood tables move.
He controls garbage molecules. Yeah.
He's been so sad for so long.
Yeah, he can mentally...
Yeah, Tom cried a hole in the wall last night.
He can mentally work himself up to performing C-level pro wrestling antics with his mind. Table destruction. Yeah.
But for real...
Oh, I was like, this is right after the suicide attempt. I was very psychotic, and they were like, "Damn, we can learn shit from strapping things to your head." And then they did a bunch of tests, and they didn't really tell me what it was for.
You tried to kill yourself, went to the hospital, and then the doctors were like, "We should do experiments on this guy."
Yeah, pretty much.
That's going to make a suicidal you feel better.
Yeah. You know, this guy needs a bunch of sensors, spirit gum to his skull.
It was.
See, this is why I don't like Obamacare.
Can't wait to see where this is going.
They also sleep deprived me for it. They're like, you can't sleep for 48 hours. And I was like,
that's not going to be a problem.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Were they just trying to get you to finish the job? Like,
I have no idea.
Like evil shit.
Yeah, no, they did that. And then they tested me for like 14 hours or something.
What's crazy
like that.
Is this is the exact plot line of Manhunt Unabomber.
I don't know that movie.
It's a TV. It sort of is. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
You should see it. It's a show on Discovery. It's great.
Okay.
But apparently the Unabomber was created when he was at college and they just did a bunch of experiments.
I love when a real life person has a fucking origin story, you know? Christopher Dorner fell in that vat marked XXX skull, then he came out and had a thirst for the blood of his white counterparts. Man, I just got back from a 4-day 2,000-mile road trip with my ex girlfriend. That was Chevy Chase level comedy badness. No, it was actually
after
fun.
You said the Chris Dorner thing, it really felt like you were gonna be. I just came back from DornerCon.
Dude, it's like Coachella. I got the wristband, but it's just sort of like a bloody like medical bracelet they've designed.
Everybody who was in the manifesto, all the famous people are like doing a panel.
Yeah. Oh, man. Margaret Cho on her influence.
Dude, the Dorner manifesto, it's the funniest thing ever because it's like, you know, all white cops should be killed. Also, Ellen is great. Like, it's real crazy.
Yeah, sorry.
No,
go for it.
No, okay. Anyway, I was just going to say this fucking trip with Jessica and I are doing this new podcast. podcast, Existential Crisis, about relationship and shit. So we did an episode on the road, and it was fun. But, like, just let me explain to you this woman. So we listened to 5 Reba McEntire songs, mm-hmm. all right? 3 of which are about God and make her furious. She's angry. She's so disappointed in Reba. The other two, crying uncontrollably, uh-huh. independently of one another. Did you know that there's 19 hours of a band called Sugarland? I found that out recently.
Oh, God.
I was so much fucking 90s country to the point that I got, like, Stockholm kind of into it.
Oh, no.
I've got all these fucking songs about finger banging and water towers stuck in my head. Yeah,
no, so now you're going to be just
that's
wearing
the worst
a track.
Music. Oh, it's God. The worst music.
100%.
Yeah.
I love
country.
The
yeah. Oh, man.
Now you're just going to be wearing a tracksuit and listening to Rascal Flatts. You're becoming 9 different terrible dudes.
Oh, yeah. And
just acting
and then
body.
She's like, I need you to Google if Eric Church is single, and then yells at me because I'm texting and driving the thing she asked me to Google. Truly a nightmare.
Yeah, Connor got home last night and was like, I gotta show you this. It's terrible, but I kinda like it. It was about finger banging on a water tower or something like that.
It's literally a song about painting a, like, Billy Bob Love Charlene on a water tower, and I'm like, I can't. It's stuck in my fucking head.
Oh, fuck.
Wow. Our hotel tonight reservation got fucked up, so we had to stay in a historic hotel, which, as we know, is code for shitty fucking hotel.
Yeah.
And we had to share one, like, extra long full bed. It was just a comical disaster. So we're just sitting next to each other, just farting and bickering. It was fucking Jesus Christ.
It kind of sounds like your dream relationship, because nobody had to fuck and you both got to be unhappy.
Honestly, yeah. I mean, if I would have gotten some sneakers, it would have been a 10 out of 10.
Got very specific unpleasant needs from a woman.
And Jessica's whole diet is just, like, beef sticks and health snacks, so she's just, like, queefing out just rancid, noxious gas, like paint melting fucking fumes every 8 minutes. And by the she's so tiny, and I'm
that
like, it must
of
ferment
the most
quicker.
Fucked up senses I've ever heard in my life.
Queefing rancid fumes?
Yeah, there's so much in there.
Well, yeah, no,
there's a lot of imagery.
Yeah. Now it's in your heads.
Right? I want to hear what she has to say about you right now, because that
word for word, same
something.
Shit.
Yeah. Yeah, Connor kept queefing up Slim Jims.
Yeah. He kept pee hole farting out fucking protein bar fucking gas.
Dude, if anybody could fart out of their wiener, it is you.
Oh, that would be.
Like, you need a new vent for negativity.
That would be great. Like, oh, tea's done. Oh, man, this is fun. I think we're all fired up. You guys want to get into the Mexican joke off?
So topical.
Let's do it. I'll take it away this week.
Hell yeah.
A woman was kicked out of a Walmart for drinking red wine out of a Pringles can. This led to Pringles' new slogan, once you pop, your kids get taken by the cops.
A Russian sex coach was arrested after claiming she had evidence of Russia's influence of the election. No info on whether this claim has merit, but for more info, go to her website, www.russianspissondesperatebillionaires.com. My God, I fucked that up 9 different directions.
I mean, yeah, first of all, I love that you chose to include www. Just
of
add
course.
More syllables.
Yeah,
Tom, really. all the jokes you do for this sound like you woke up and tapped them down in the middle of the night and then did not check them later.
What the fuck is a Russian sex coach?
That's what I keep thinking. Speaking of tracksuits, that guy's got to have every color. You know? I guess
the stripes are just... Come.
She just, like, has an Instagram and then goes to Thailand and is like, you want to do this with your pussy? And people are like, that's good.
Yeah, because I see all these, like, orgasm workshops or, like, the cunnilingus class. And I'm like, who is, like, weird enough to get, like, watch a YouTube video? Like,
you know, Pornhub has instructional videos.
I hope it's for, like, how to waterproof a deck. I mean,
me too. Just, I would, like, love to out. Jerk off to that.
That would be fun to have just, like, hey, here's how to balance your checkbook, but the lady's just naked, you know? I feel like that's probably a creepy business we could start.
I feel like that definitely exists. That has to exist. I feel like I've seen that, actually.
I've seen topless movie reviews where it's just girls being like, yeah, I thought that Splice kind of, like, fell apart in the third act.
I saw the same thing, but with Roger Ebert.
Really?
Yeah, he is hot.
Dude, right. Fat tits, no jaw. That's a good look.
It's actually his name.
All right, guys. A Chicago police officer who's...
Nah, that's it. You're done.
Karma it up.
I'm going to come back to that one. Doctors are warning women not to follow the advice of magazine Marie Claire, which advised readers to put parsley in their vaginas. One medical expert wrote, "We garnish your wages, not your pushies. Get it right, you goofy broads." I almost made.
I like that you did Italian fingers to really get the misogyny across.
I almost made that guy just Dice Clay until I remembered he's been done about 8 times already.
Yeah.
All right. Gladys Knight will be singing the national anthem at this year's Super Bowl. She's gotten a lot of flack for it. And when asked for a comment in a recent interview on why she agreed to do it, she said, because I'm a piece of shit.
Who's Gladys Knight?
That piece of shit.
Yeah, yeah. Some shitty old lady.
Some dumb whore whose Twitter is about to blow up.
She's a Motown singer. She had this. She had three
she's
fat
great.
Backup dancers called the Pips, who just did adorable fat. It's like if the Charmin Bears like sang with the Temptations.
What's,
basically,
what's her big song?
Midnight Train to Georgia.
Oh yeah, that yeah. one. That's
oh
a song.
Yeah. She was huge.
She did a version of Heard It Through the Grapevine that was quite popular. You know. Yeah. She's great, but yeah. I don't know. Piece
three
of shit.
Yeah. You heard it here first.
Big Chris Dorner fan.
Oh, yeah. Loves that, dude. Man, I was working a door-to-door sales job when
you were
Dorner
working door-to-door?
you beat me to it.
But I was down in Orange County when that was happening. It was, like, right in the neighborhood.
Yeah, I remember
that. And I remember one time, we're going, like, door-to-door, me and my friend, and this cop car rolls up, and I see her go up to talk to the cops because they wave her over. And then she just starts crying, and she said when she got there, the cops were just driving around with their guns out in their hand. And I'm pretty sure this small white girl is not Christopher Dorner.
Oh, I almost got shot because of that piece of shit.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about this weird story.
Yeah. Well, I went over to my friend's house. Because
it turns out Tom drives the same car as every scorned police murderer. He's got the same demo.
Yeah. Right. I was coming back from my friend's house because she was all trying to kill herself and shit. And I'm driving home and I...
Or as Tom calls it, errands.
And there's a solid red light. It wasn't flashing. It was just a solid red light behind me. Uh-huh. And I was like, oh, that's a cop. But they're not doing the flashies, so I guess I'm good. And I drive like another six blocks, and I'm like, oh, he's following me. So then I pull over, and gun was drawn, fucking...
Jesus.
Yeah, no, he was super ready to shoot me.
I mean, you were driving around in blackface. I don't know what you thought was going to happen.
Yeah.
Well, I know it keeps the sun out of your eyes like a football player, but I've told you...
Three children were found dead in a freezer. Let this be a lesson, kids. Next time you play Avengers, not everybody gets to be Captain America.
That's pretty great. A man went on a deadly hammer rampage in a Brooklyn restaurant. He claims he was trying to pick up the laser sword or the Pokeball, but the items were right next to each other.
Yeah. I heard Hammer Rampage, and I was like thinking, like, oh, I'm going to do a Smash Bros. Riff. And I'm like, oh, that was way better.
Man, if you can kill two guys with a hammer before someone stops you, you're pretty good at having a hammer.
Yeah, yeah.
Did I ever tell the story about the Greyhound hammer guy?
No.
This is one right after I got dumped about 4 years ago. I took a 24-hour Greyhound bus ride to go not be able to get up at NACA West.
Oh, I think I remember.
I had about $7 total, and I'm just like I'm just living off of some giant bag of cashews I stole or something.
Right.
And I'm just like sick and miserable, and I just was fucking the worst I've ever felt in my life.
Yeah.
And I get on this Greyhound bus going back, and it's winter time. It's snowing outside. I'm fucking freezing. I have nothing going on in my life that's good.
Yeah.
And I get on this bus, and then wide open Greyhound. Every seat is open. There's like six people. Guess who sits right next to me? Fucking Zach De La Rocha with a cardboard box with about seven different kinds of hammers. So
no.
He sits next to me in the aisle seat, and he starts like, as if he were a doting mother tending to his children, he puts one hammer in the cup holder. He puts one on the windowsill.
You're fucking with
he
me.
He puts one in my lap. He puts one in his lap. He holds one in his hand, and he's just sitting there waiting. There's also a large bottle
they're
of
hammers?
Liquor.
Like hammers.
Yeah, fucking hammer ass, claw hammers, fucking rubber mallets. He's got some finishing hammers, a little sledgehammer.
He's the lead singer of Rage Against the Machine.
Yeah, just a dreadlocked. Like,
so you're dealing with white dreadlocks and a multitude of hammers.
Wait, and what year is this?
This is 2014.
And he's taking the bus?
He's taking the bus. With all of his
this
hammers.
This is a millionaire.
And at one point, I get up and I go shit in the bathroom. And I come back and my phone charger is just it's covered, like the part that goes in the phone.
In hammers.
Full hammer coverage.
No, my phone charger is covered in this acrid, sticky, like weird chemical smelling sticky goo.
Right.
So now my phone is dead, and it's like 6 hours to the next stop, and I have nothing to do but sit there and sweat next to Johnny Hammers. You know, so I get out, I go walk like eight blocks through downtown Sacramento, and the Greyhound, believe it or not, doesn't stop in the most awesome part of Sacramento.
No, it stops in Sacramento.
Yeah, so
Sacramento.
I'm just like this little fucking like white dork with an afro walking through downtown downtown Sacramento at 2 a.m, spending my last $8 on a phone charger so I can listen to the Joe DeRosa Spotify or something before I go to bed. And yeah, then Hammer Guy got kicked off because they saw his bottle of booze, and he just ran away.
It was the booze, not the multitude of hammers.
No, I mean, I guess those are within the Greyhound carry-on policy, because no one really remarked on him. I was going to be the one to make a scene.
Hammer time, fine, but if you got a little bit of liquor, that's the issue.
Yeah, man. Anyway.
Okay.
Wait, I just... Where...
Dave, as many questions you have, I have five more and no answers.
Also, can I tell you how long I went in that story before I realized that it was a metaphor that you said Zach De La Rocha?
Yeah, and I wasn't going to correct
it. I literally thought you meant Zach De La Rocha. I said he got on the bus. I was like losing my mind.
Oh, that's why you asked what year it was, and I was like, whoa.
Yeah, that's why I asked what year it was.
I was confused, and then when you believed it, I was like, well, if Dave believes it, he's way smarter than me.
Here's the thing. It is pretty crazy that Zach De La Rocha might do that shit with hammers and get on a bus, but it's not completely not believable.
The hammer stuff makes it more believable.
It's right on the edge of like those like Richard Gere Goebbels.
Wait, what?
When Richard Gere put a Nazi propagandist in his ass? No, it's like a very.
Yeah, they pulled a 95-year-old German man out of Richard Gere's anus.
God damn it.
What if that is the
Captain
rumor?
America.
I love that, dude.
Well, you know, that guy puts Goebbels in his ass.
One boot is missing off him when he comes out, and then Richard Gere just farts out a jack boot.
Oh, man. That was the best face typo I've ever made in my life.
Anyway, here's my joke. Good luck following that, Connor. A Chicago police officer who killed an unarmed teen in 2014 was sentenced to 7 years in prison. The judge ruled that the cop used a racial slur and excessive force, which means his special meter was all the way charged at the time of the attack. That's the cop finishing move. You can use your ultimate finisher.
Yeah.
If you have your
press N.
No, it's a quarter circle N.
You're up.
I don't think a guest has ever done that, and I'm so glad you did just make us sit in our lack of.
Somebody just took a hammer to the momentum.
I just felt like I just saw Dave weigh the amount of kind of fun he's having to how detrimental this is going to his very like upward moving career. Just kind of like, well, I do like these guys, but I mean, at a certain point, we've got a family to feed.
While that is a very nice compliment, Connor, it was more like I was like, would it be funny to me if it were quiet?
It was very funny to me.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite things that's like happened on this show.
Do you like how insecure just one beat of not riffing makes me just go, well, Dave is clearly thinking that his friendship with me is detrimental to his life.
If it's quiet for 9 seconds, Connor just unravels like a ball of yarn. Yeah. Like
it's been almost 200 episodes. That is the first moment of silence we've ever had on Mean Boys.
Yeah.
It's never happened before.
I don't know. I've listened to a couple of the episodes that I wasn't here for. And
bitch.
Hey.
Fuck you guys.
Yeah, we suck.
Yeah,
kidding.
We need to hear.
You should try to kill yourself again.
Yeah. I'm just trying to get that sweet, sweet phone, baby.
Honestly, I feel like
I want that cracked iPhone 3.
Yeah, if Tom tries to kill himself again, he's gonna get Dr. Octopus tentacles.
I can't believe you're in the hospital and they were like, we can use this brain.
They paid me $50.
Yeah, oh, okay, so it's cool.
Oh, wow.
That'll
help you pay the medical bill.
That's like how we bought Mexico for like $600 after we raped everybody out of it.
Offering you $50 is so much more insulting than offering you nothing.
Oh, yeah.
If they offer you nothing, it's like, well, it's for science, but $50 is like, yeah, we can buy him off and poke his brain with a fucking
stick.
What's
hilarious, the only thing they were able to tell me is they're like, yeah, for your diagnosis, all of your hand-eye coordination and reflexes are off the chart. I'm like, I don't. That's it. That's all you're going to tell me. This is for is that you're surprised I can move.
That's not the issue. I didn't not die because Butterfingers.
Sounds like you're
fingers.
Reading Tom Goss fan fiction to us.
Sometimes I genuinely do forget what Tom shit is real and what is shit we've riffed on it.
Like, yeah, this is the great thing about knowing Tom is like I talk to him every day. He's my best friend. No one in the world makes me happier. But and then every 3 weeks I hear a new unbelievable thing that I just didn't know. And he's like, oh, I never told you about when I was a frisbee golf caddy and played the big game for $1 million. And then got my feet broken by the mob. And I'm like, no! He's like, oh, yeah, I did that.
Yeah, I haven't had any mob run-ins. I did flunk out of a golf class once, though.
If you said the words golf college, I was going to throw you through
the
window.
It wasn't college. It was at a junior college.
Golf junior college.
How did you flunk out? Were you bad at it?
I was really bad
That's
at it.
That's the most unambitious Orange County burnout path available.
Yeah.
Junior golf college.
I thought I was going to be really good. I swear to God, this is my logic. I was like, oh, I'm good at hockey, and I saw Happy Gilmore. This should be a great transition. And I ended up hitting several people with the ball, and they asked me to drop the class.
Oh, man. Wonderful.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah. Great,
it's a class.
Do you realize?
I can't believe you got asked to drop a class. Like, the class is supposed to teach you to be good.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, yeah, you cannot
No, you
learn.
Will not be good.
I need people to understand that I live a life where Paul Bunyan is in my kitchen. Do you understand? It's fucking incredible.
You have a lot of weird school stories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Special ed dropout. Dave is trying to bring the energy down, Tom.
Yeah, yeah.
If you please indulge his alti bit.
Look, man, I came up on the east side.
That's how we do it in Silver Lake.
We piss people off until they laugh uncomfortably. Prince Philip was in a car crash 2 days ago that injured two passengers in another car. Authorities are unsure what the cause of, and at this point, they are assuming he was driving drunk because he is only 97 years old.
That dude must rage.
Is that the dude who boned Diana?
No, that's Prince Charles.
Okay.
I mean, maybe he did, too. I don't know how they get there.
Well, how's he related to Diana?
He was behind the guy that T-boned Diana, because, as we know, she was killed by the crown.
Indeed, and now we can say that.
For getting hogged down by a Muslim. Now, that's an ironic thing to have a Muslim do to you because of the pork, but it did happen, and it was very controversial.
You thought up the phrase hogged down and really just went above and beyond to figure out a way to make it work.
Yeah, sometimes I just start talking, and it's like when Batman jumps off a building. I'm like, I'll find an awning somewhere. I'll grapple my way through this one.
That's the most honest shit I've ever heard you say.
Yeah.
40 homosexual men were arrested in a Chechenian gay purge. This is not to be confused with the West Hollywood gay purge, which is when you let a dude throat fuck you until you puke up brunch.
I thought the West Hollywood gay purge is when there's just no rules at the Abbey for one day.
Yeah, so every day.
Yeah.
Everyone knows the gay bars.
I did a Postmates from the Abbey once, like 4 years ago, and I was just walking in, and everyone just sort of is looking at me and like kind of like sizing me up, and I'm like, I'm just trying to get some cookies. And I was like, oh, I feel like I'm intruding on the gay spaces. It was kind of uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Yeah. God damn it, phone. A Texas woman gave birth to a 14-pound baby. Vaginal Ambassador Smirnoff says, in Soviet Russia, that size baby births you.
You piece of shit.
Dude, fucking top.
Hey. Vaginal Ambassador.
Your chopped liver now, Dice Clay. Hello, Yakov jokes.
Vaginal Ambassador.
Oh, fuck you.
How did you even write that? That's crazy.
I'm a vaginal ambassador. I have a promo code I use on Instagram.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
I thought that one was going to bomb. I'm very happy right now.
The funniest thing you've ever said.
Yeah, I love it, man.
The vaginal embassy.
Oh, yeah. The butthole. It's
oh, man. But you remember what happened at Punghazi?
Punghazi. So many good episode titles. I mean, Richard Gere Goebbels.
It's a vaginal ambassador. I don't know why we're even entertaining the idea it's anything else.
Yeah. All right, guys. A petition for Alabama to end their combined Martin Luther King and Robert E. Lee holiday has over 14,000 signatures. Lawmakers aren't happy about the campaign, with one state senator saying, what's next? Should we get rid of the annual feral dog ham baby picnic?
I like that they combine Robert E. Lee and Martin Luther King. Isn't that the goofiest shit you ever heard in your life? They have the same day for them.
Yeah, that's sitcom logic.
And I'm like, just because two people share a birthday.
Right.
Yeah, they were like about the opposite shit mostly.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Yeah, you might say.
Yeah.
I can think of one thing they might have agreed on, but.
Yeah. King's
women?
More of a coffee guy.
White
woman.
I said white women.
Yeah, oh, that's funny.
Cheating on your wife.
Yeah,
yeah.
Hair. Right. They both had. Oh no, never mind. Martin Luther King was bald, wasn't he?
No, nope. He had hair.
No, okay. I was thinking of
Robert.
You were
thinking of DMX.
Bald.
I had a dream. X gonna let you vote.
George W. Bush posted a photo of himself on Instagram delivering pizzas to his Secret Service detail because, according to Bush, he wanted to show that he appreciates them while they're working for no pay during the government shutdown. But sources inside the Bush family home have reported that Bush has always paid his Secret Service agents in pizza. It's interesting, one agent told us, because we definitely get a paycheck, and it's a lot of money. They pay us a shitload of money because we might die protecting that guy. But sure enough, every week, Mr. Bush hands me a pizza and says, here's your paycheck. And he never laughs when he says that. I think he actually thinks pizza is money. Mr. Bush and Laura Bush have declined to comment, but Vice President Dick Cheney told the BBC, oh, he definitely thinks pizza is money. Donald Rumsfeld told Reuters yesterday that George W. Bush thinks pizza is money. The Daily Mail asked current U.S. President Donald Trump for a comment, who told them, since when is pizza not money? Since then, several smart Jewish people have pointed out that both George Bush and Donald Trump have been elected president by the American people, so pizza is definitely money.
Smart Jewish people.
I'm so mad right now because once again...
No, you do not have that joke.
No, no, I don't have that joke. But once again, I have a worse pizza joke, just like the banana follow-up.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my
yeah,
God.
Yeah, well, we clearly have the same interests.
Yeah, bananas, pizza, presidents.
Yeah, don't worry. I also have a significantly worse pizza joke I will now not be doing.
Oh, I'm going to do mine.
Oh, my God. The TSA is in trouble due to the government shutdown. Some are worried this may lead to another 9/11, but thankfully the shutdown also affected the government agencies that planned the first
9/11. Nice.
9/11.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Hey, is that
9/11.
Power over there? Because I'm speaking truth to something.
You know what's weird?
Get fucked.
Wow.
Ratio.
Hey, are those steel beams over there? Because I'm not melting them with my jet fuel.
Does fucking Trump know?
I was trying to shit on you.
That
it
it's
didn't work.
The government he shut down
like
that
no,
protects the border right now. Like, is he aware that what he's doing is bad for his bottom line too, or does he just?
I mean,
wait,
yeah.
What?
We welcome now MSNBC's newest analyst, Tom Goss.
We welcome now Vaginal News Ambassador Tom Goss.
Tom, is McConnell going to cave, or is he too worried about losing the Trump base in the 2019 election?
Okay, I'm gonna.
Yeah,
go
I don't
back
know, but
I
got a pretty good joke about how the Noid used to work for W. You want to hear it?
George W. Bush delivered pizza to the Secret Service. It's great to see that now that his dad's dead, he's comfortable doing work he's qualified for.
Damn,
that was good. Yeah. That was a good joke.
I'm serious. You can sell that to Bill Maher or something.
Oh yeah, he doesn't know me.
Oh really? you guys came up to
that's weird. He did the show. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Now liberals, the Republicans. That's my one word Bill Maher impression. Republicans.
Did he really do the show?
What? No.
Oh okay. Yeah. I mean, you know, you never know.
With that one,
you know, pretty confident.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
true.
Pretty much do now.
I would love to meet him just for his reaction.
Oh, man. He. Oh,
I would love to see you meet him, too, and then realize in that moment you were thinking of Bill Nye. Yes.
So when are you going to teach me about centripetal force?
Yeah, like I guess you don't like this Pelosi lady, but that doesn't help me build a volcano. Yes. So.
Where's the magic bus?
Yes. All right, guys. A 33-year-old man is facing sexual assault charges, and in his defense, he claimed that an 11-year-old girl got pregnant from his clothes. Now, that sounds like bullshit, but to be fair, he was wearing Wilt Chamberlain skin at the time in question. That's not my
needs more pizza.
Yeah.
I
should have done the one about the guy shooting jizz into his back.
You always got to do that one.
Dude, always bet on jizz.
I am out. Yeah, all right. I'm done.
Okay.
That's cool. Do I have any more? Yeah, I got one more.
I think of that pizza joke as a special two-part episode.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I feel like I did put a lot of effort into that, yeah.
You hit a walk-off home run. You know, you could just sit silently or leave, and it would still be the best appearance we've had
that
on the show.
That was Star Trek Next Generation, all good things, you know? Yeah.
Joe Andres, wife of actor Steve Buscemi, passed away this week. She will be remembered for her contributions to the arts and her years of charity work with Steve Buscemi's penis.
This is the last one, right?
What a trooper.
Yeah, you're ugly, guy with a dead wife. We do a nice show here.
Oh, man. Yeah, we gotta. At some point, we gotta figure something out.
Just in general.
With her whole worldview here.
Yeah.
I have no view. This is the last one?
Yeah.
Okay, this one's
the last one ever.
Yeah, you have no view? I've been telling you to clean that kitchen window for years.
Yeah, you said I have no view as a throwaway. Yeah. I love that so much. I have no view anyway.
Lakers player Michael Beasley tried to enter the game wearing the wrong shorts. People noticed when Martin Short started yelling, "Hey, get me off this dude's waist."
Damn,
for fuck's sake.
That was crazy. Yeah.
He's wearing a guy's pants.
He's wearing a moderately respected Canadian actor of note.
Oh, man.
Wonderful. All right, and finally, a 27-year-old quadriplegic man has fulfilled his lifelong dream of starring in a porno film. Producers were impressed with his performance, saying, "Look at the eggplant on that vegetable."
Ah, yes! Yes!
We have a worldview, and it's that joke. It's look at that man. Wheelchair fella's big old hog.
Yeah, baby. All right, that was a Mexican joke. What a time, everybody. We'll be right back right after this.
Gillette's recent ad campaign, Standing Up to Toxic Masculinity, made headlines around the world. The commercial was powerful, heart-wrenching, and showed the men of America that there is a way to combat decades of toxic behavior by buying Gillette razors. We here at McDonald's realized we needed to step up. It is the responsibility of corporations to make bold, sweeping, generally agreeable social stands. Corporations are people too, so we must be the best publicly traded, multinational people we can be. After all, if the corporations won't stand up for the little guy, then who will? Poor people? That's why McDonald's is proud to say that we do not support child molestation in any way, shape, or form. We stand for many things here at McDonald's. Serving America the finest freshness-adjacent ingredients. Play places that are 73% syringe-free. The God-given right of all American people to life, liberty, and two free sauces with every order of Chicken McNuggets. But when it comes to the sexual exploitation of children, we here at McDonald's say right here, right now, we are taking a stand, and we are not loving it. Many big companies talk a big game, but McDonald's is ready to walk the walk. From now on, if you molest a child at McDonald's, you will be asked to leave. We are also officially discontinuing our practice of handing out free Happy Meal toys to middle-aged men who say they need help, quote, keeping a situation quiet. And as of today, all McDonald's franchises worldwide will no longer be offering our controversial McFlurry flavor, Kid Wiener. Because the only way we're okay with disappointing children is with our terrible, perpetually broken ice cream machines. Many of our followers on Twitter have been critical of this campaign. Some say there's no real connection between child molestation and McDonald's hamburgers. Others say this whole thing reeks of a craven attempt to monetize wokeness by a company that still pays its workers slave wages while contributing to the obesity crisis that is destroying the lives of millions of kids. Now, is McDonald's saying that anybody who criticizes this ad is a child molester? Are we saying that the Burger King himself flies to that island where Bill Clinton and Steven Spielberg go to score some tiny strange? Are we saying that anybody who goes to Chick-fil-A is an active pedophile and that every chicken finger bought hurts the same as an uncle finger inserted? Of course not. That's for the public to decide. So, you know, feel free to tweet that exactly at them. You guys are cool, right? So join McDonald's in taking a stand against child molestation, a position we have held firmly and proudly since the long ago days of last week. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, don't rape a kid.
The Mean Boys podcast is brought to you by Stitch Fix.
Now,
Stitch Fix, it's an online personal styling service that finds and delivers clothes, shoes, and accessories to fit your body, budget, and lifestyle.
Okay.
All right. Now, if we were to pick one member of the Mean Boys podcast, who's got some particular difficulties in the area of body? Less so, but sure.
Yeah.
Budget, certainly. Lifestyle, red alert, disaster. I mean, this is the perfect service for you, Tom.
Keith's right there.
I am a well-dressed man, and I require no assistance. I would use Stitch Fix. I was looking through, and they have some really nice shit.
Oh, yeah. Well, dude, it's like you can just like have it fucking, you know, Postmates to your ass.
Dude, yeah, it's just swag in a box.
And like, I also like, I think a lot of Mean Boys fans, it's like, you want to look like a guy, you want to be a person, but you don't spend a lot of time, you know, like, you don't give a shit about what colors go together, and it's like, just let someone else do that so you can get back to living your life.
Yeah, these these guys are great. They literally figure out what's going to look good on you. They mail it to you. You keep the stuff you like. Anything you don't like, you mail back. You don't got to pay for it.
You know what it is? It's fucking date night in a box. They just send you a perfect like date outfit, and then you're
and
fucking good to go.
What's great about this service is that we know Tom gets most of his clothes from, you know, finding it in various garbages.
Right, right.
So because it's mailed to you, it's like, oh, I found it. Well, like, no, you didn't have to go to a store.
It's on perfect the ground for me because I need clothes technically, but I hate outside, so I don't get them. But they just ship it to me.
I've spent 8 months trying to get Tom to go buy a T-shirt.
I bought the T-shirt I'm wearing. I bought it from a homeless transvestite at the comedy store.
You're wearing it, but
yeah, but no, this is perfect for Tom. And it's you know, they have like a personal stylist guy that goes like, ah, what's good for this fucking asshole.
I think my box is on the way.
Yeah, it's on the way. We're getting. I can't wait to debut Runway Tom.
Yeah, we will be doing a full on fashion show.
Yeah,
you know, and they pick it all up, they send it to you. And there's what I like is there's no subscriptions, so where you sign up for something and then you forget about it, and you're like, oh, fuck. If you want to just get one box and kick the tires, and then maybe like, hey, let's do it every month. Like every 3 months, I want to spruce up the wardrobe. Like,
yeah,
take it in at your pace, which is kind of nice.
You're gonna want it every month, but try one.
Yeah, you can make it monthly. You can make it a one time thing. You can make it every 3 months. Like they have a lot of options, and then you just select the kind of shit you like, and then based off of that, they send you outfits, which I think is a genius way to do it.
You get like a whole like astrology BuzzFeed kind of quiz that's fun, and you're like, you know what? I wouldn't wear that. I'm better than you, North Face. And you get to feel smart. You know, that's nice.
I found out the princess I am is Cinderella, and they're sending me some chinos.
I'm about to be a very fashionable Samantha. So all you got to do is go to StitchFix.com/meanboys. Get started now at StitchFix.com/meanboys, and you get an extra 25% off when you keep all 5 items in your box. That's StitchFix.com/meanboys to get started today. Let's see if I can say it one more time.
StitchFix.com/pawns.
Go to snatchfacts.biz. Enter promo code
StitchFix.com/meanboys.
Mean boys. Back to the show.
Mean. Welcome back to the Mean Boys podcast. We return with a middle segment I made this morning that might be one of the stupidest ideas I've ever had for a game.
I'm so excited.
This game is called Do or Don't. And basically what this is I'm going to read you the name of a thing, and you guys have to guess if it is a flavor of Mountain Dew or a Nazi band.
Wonderful.
Yeah. And I was like, there's no way this will be that hard. It's actually way harder than I thought it would be.
Oh, not hell for me.
I know. I was embarrassed when I looked at the list of Nazi bands. I'm like, I know more of these offhand than I should.
God, that sucks.
I mean, it's three, but like, it's still three too many.
I'm definitely going to know some of the Nazi bands.
Yeah, Code Prussian Blue.
I had to cut Prussian Blue because we've joked about that weird ass Nazi band.
Everybody knows Prussian Blue.
I went deep cuts, I think. So I don't know. We'll see. Let's start here.
Take the gerbil out of your ass.
That's so funny.
It's so dumb.
He had gerbils in his ass.
And he was also wearing Martin shorts.
Oh, my God. You got to take your Martin shorts off if you want to put the gerbils in your ass.
What's the worst Nazi you can put up your butt? He's got all those medals. It's just going to be pokey up there.
Call the vagina ambassador.
All those medals that he earned.
You know, for bravery and stuff. Anyway, Thunderbolt. Is that a Nazi band or a brand of Mountain Dew?
Oh, man. This is actually pretty hard.
That's got to be a Nazi band.
Okay.
I think the Thunderbolt's the white Gatorade. Oh, wait, no. We're talking about Mountain Dew.
Tom, I'm going to tell you this right now. The answer is definitely not Gatorade. Yeah.
Also, I got to figure all Gatorade is the white Gatorade. We're pretty big fans of it. I think I've probably talked more about how much I love Gatorade on this podcast than, like, my relationship with my father
100%.
Or, like, politics.
Dude, you really do, you, like, all parts of the buffalo with Gatorade because you drink the Gatorade, then you pee in the bottle. And, like, you're like...
One time you drank the pee.
So. Dude, and that was the worst part about the road trip with Jessica is I couldn't piss in bottles, so I had to pull over every 45 minutes.
Why couldn't you piss in a bottle?
I just...
What's she going to do? What, are you going to break up with her again? Like,
no, it seemed like it would have made her uncomfortable. I didn't ask. Like, Nicole Buchanan, she was like, Connor, I just want to get there on time. Piss in a bottle. I don't care. I'm the kind of girl you can pee in a water bottle in front of.
I'm not like other girls. Yeah, but
when it's your whore ex-girlfriend.
I'm not that kind of boy.
Are you not a bottle pisser?
I'm not. I mean, I was kidding. If it came to it,
Dave
you could
was
pee
also
in front
30
of me,
minutes
but...
late today. So maybe there was a connection.
That's true.
Maybe one of us takes our career a little more serious.
I like that Dave stopped to pee 3 times on the 15-minute drive.
Well, that's why that wall fell down.
You pissed a wall.
I pissed in a water bottle.
I thought it fell down because Tom, I don't know, remembered a sad memory from his childhood. Yeah.
I've pissed in a water bottle on hilariously short trips, but I am going to say that Thunderbolt is a white power band.
All right, we got 2 white powers.
You guys ever overflow the bottle with pee?
Yes.
No, I got a pretty good pinch off. It's happened, but rarely.
Damn, I always pinch off. I think that's the part that makes me not want to do it.
Yeah?
I don't understand, like, actually, I'm very curious. I've never understood what situation there is where you need to pee in a bottle. Like, how late can you possibly be? Because it's one thing if it's in town. That I actually understand more than on a road trip.
Yeah.
Because on a road trip, it's like a 9-hour drive or whatever the fuck it is. How could you be that late?
Road trip, it's a matter of convenience. But
okay.
In town, I mean, there's a lot of shit where it's
Because
the
like, driver doesn't want to stop or
there's
whatever.
There's a lot of shit where I lose track of time. I'm not a great schedule. So I'm like, fuck, I got to be in Santa Monica at 3:30. I don't want to do get to the meeting and the first thing I got to do is go piss. I just want to piss.
That
and be
makes
ready to
way
clean
more sense.
I do not believe you because you also just pee in bottles in your room.
I do sometimes.
I came
cozy.
In here one time,
oh, wow.
And
oh,
Connor is just shoving what like
I tried
with
to
his
Fonzie
foot,
a big jug of pee,
like
out
it
of the
was
way
a dead
Thomas.
Cat that he was murdering. And I look over there; it is a gallon jug of piss. The right where that water bottle is, he just shoved it into his closet.
Well,
like,
it looks like you just got uninvited from my Jankum party, Tom.
And
I hope you're happy.
Why is there a giant bottle of piss? And he goes, it's kind of cold in the bathroom. I go, that's where I sleep. You can just walk over there and pee.
Hey, guys, we get it. I'm gross, okay? The answer to all of these questions is I'm a gross pig that doesn't care about society. Do you see?
I love it. I love it.
Tom, Thunderbolt, not
Gatorade.
No.
Or, sorry.
Yeah, we're on the Raid or Don't game.
The only wrong answer, for sure. I'm going to go with Mountain Dew.
Paper right. or plastic? Mexicans.
That's a Nazi band.
Yeah.
Number 2, Whiteout.
That's Mountain Dew for sure.
Okay.
Double misdirected.
I still think it's a Gatorade, but yeah, I'm going to go with Dew.
All right, that is Mountain Dew.
Well, in fairness, that is also the white power Mountain Dew flavor.
Yeah. They're like, it's a dog whistle Mountain Dew.
It's the Nazi Mountain Dew, totally.
Yeah. We know what we're about.
Is it made to taste like actual Whiteout? Is it for like, you know, problem children that would eat paste and things
like
that?
You can drink it and huff it because Mountain Dew is your life. Next one, Alliance Blue.
Fuck.
Ooh, Alliance leads me to believe that this could be some sort of World of Warcraft tie-in Dew flavor. Mountain Dew is no stranger to a Call of Duty collab, you know? It's like when Bape and Adidas get together, but for fat
guys. Is that true?
Yeah. I mean,
they've done a Call of Duty collab?
Oh, yeah.
Dave Ross, so many.
Is that true?
Yeah.
There's a whole Call of Duty like line of Mountain Dews.
No fucking way.
Yeah, there
it
were
might
like,
be Monster that I think of it, but I've definitely seen a lot of video game drinks, you know?
Yeah, there were Mountain Dews, too. There was a Mountain Dew and a Doritos where you could buy them and they would give you XP in Call of Duty. It was the fattest, saddest promotion.
This has to be a Mountain Dew, then.
They line up with it. Fucking everything. In sixth grade, we went on a camping trip to Yosemite for the school, and the car I was with robbed a 7-Eleven of a Darth Dew poster. I had no option, but the dad was very gung-ho about robbing their
The dad stole the Darth Dew.
Yes.
Yeah, the chaperone stole the Star Wars Mountain Dew item.
I like the idea that they got all the way to Yosemite, then realized you were not supposed to be with them. You were just some other kid from somewhere else who had gotten in a van.
Your whole life is like Bad News Bears with trauma instead of baseball. These amazing stories about... Yeah, and then the person I was supposed to trust the most gave me the gun. I'm going to say that that's a Mountain Dew flavor, Keith.
All right, we're going Mountain Dew.
I'm going to do.
You're going to do? That is Mountain Dew. That is exactly a World of Warcraft.
Wow.
Oh,
wow.
Mountain Dew. Bonus point to Connor.
Cons over here.
Yeah. It's a 3-pointer.
Next one, MDX.
Ooh.
He's going to give it to you.
MDX Junior.
MDX.
Kill all your sperm, and then do gonna deliver to you. You'll kill all your sperm, then your girl won't deliver for you.
The ingredients of MDX DMX is just yellow 5, black 1,000.
Open up the door, it's P. Knock knock. Shut up, mom. I'm trying to see. Yeah, shit. MDX, that feels to me like they're like a new Coke, you know? Like them trying like MDX. We're just KFC, like a rebrand that kind of blew up in their face.
Okay.
But I don't know. I mean, I'm going to guess Mountain Dew, but I'm very very open to the idea of being wrong on this one.
I'm saying Nazi Band.
Okay.
See, it's MDF or X?
X.
Okay, so that's that'll be Mountain Dew X.
Mountain Man Dew Xenophobia.
Or
honestly, think of racist words that start with X.
I think the MDX could stand for Mountain Dew X, and it would still be a Nazi band.
Blood and soil and code red.
And I would believe that DMX were in that band.
Have I ever told the story about Ironclad on the podcast?
Yeah.
Okay, well, just real quick, Dave, you might enjoy this. I hosted a Battle of the Bands in Corona when I was like 2 years into comedy. And I had to do 15 minutes between all these local bands, you know, while they're setting up and tearing down. I had 9 minutes of material.
Sure.
It was a fucking nightmare. But yeah. You know, I needed the $75. I had to dress up like Han Solo because it was called Band Wars and it was vaguely Star Wars themed. It was fucking brutal.
What a nightmare.
But yeah, and it was like a bringer show for bands. They were just performing for their friends, and when their friends' band was off, they would leave and a new people would truck in, you know. So I'm on stage, it's the last band of the night. It's a white power metal band called Ironclad, and they just are so over my pithy 20-year-old observations about dating while you're trying to live with your parents, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm on stage going like, hey, have you guys noticed some Mexicans do this? And then about 28 skinheads just start chanting Ironclad, Ironclad, and like banging shit, and I'm just up there like, and another thing.
Here's how you know you're bombing is if you look like you, a very Aryan-looking dude, and you're still bombing in front of Nazis.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They should be trying to milk me for the future generations, but
I'm trying to figure out if there's any real Nazi, like my dead to Zion or something. Like I'm trying to figure out.
Honestly, not a bad guess.
Yeah.
Megadeth Zion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I feel like the odds are most likely Mountain Dew, so I'm going to go Dew.
MDX is Mountain Dew.
Nice.
Yeah. Damn it.
What's do you know the backstory on that one?
A long time ago. In the field of dead fish.
We finally counted that far into the alphabet.
MDX, it's like...
One Dew for the mortal man.
Tell us like another Mountain Dew story,
tell
Father.
Tell me tales of the Dew, Papa.
Father, what was Dew country like?
The fourth time I ever did the Dew.
a pan flute starts playing.
Picard is there.
Yeah, no, it's like some rebrand and like a more extreme can. All right, I got two more.
More extreme cans. What are we talking, Pamela Anderson in 96?
Nice, dude.
Yeah. Dude, she got fucking nipples, bro.
We're talking Tommy Lee.
Hell yeah, dude. He drove a boat with his dick, bro.
Stern.
It was fucking great.
Sex.
If this riff goes for 30 more seconds, we'll become the show people assume a show called Mean Boys
yeah,
is.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've always been it.
Yeah, which of Pam Anderson's tits is better, the left one or the right one? Yeah. I'm going to say trick question. It's her butt.
Well, we're all about lack of a...
I was trying to interrupt you and do the same bit. I was like, fuck you, Gabe.
Oh, man.
Taking right. My shitty bit.
Mountain Dew or Nazi band, Johnson City Gold.
Oh, Nazi band. I feel like Mountain Dew doesn't tie...
They're not going to make a Johnson City flavor. Also, that could just be a comedian.
I'd like to buy...
then it would be Johnson City to Funny Man Gold. Yeah.
I'd like to buy Pam Anderson the one day we took it to Johnson City Gold. I'll pay for the whole airfare.
Give it a Johnson City White.
Ooh. Johnson City.
I watched barbed wire in a Motel 6 in Johnson City, that, my friend, was some Johnson City gold.
Take me down to Johnson City where I have daydreams about jiggling titties.
Wow. Oh, won't you please call me dad? Johnson City, between the exits of left thigh and right thigh. You get down and stay a spell, whore.
Population. Going.
I think I figured out the trick to this game is you just have to figure out the name and imagine Mountain Dew font. Now, if it is more douchey than that font just saying Mountain Dew, it is the actual soda. This would look less douchey. I'm going to say band.
Oh, all that's right.
It's got to be a band.
D-E-W-C-H-E-Y, douchey.
We got bands all the way across. That is Mountain Dew.
What?
No.
That is, they put out like a poll in cities who wanted to name a Mountain Dew after them, and it was Johnson City, Tennessee, and they got like way the most votes.
Wow.
What?
Yeah, there was like a whole run of them, and they're all just named after these like tragic fucking gas station cities because they're the most obsessed with Mountain Dew.
Yeah.
Whoa. I love that.
Delano Platinum.
If that's what they had their bonding Dogville moment is to just get Mountain Dew named.
Delary Select.
Larry Select.
Dude, that's the only kind of cigarettes you smoke, actually.
Yeah. It costs 98 cents.
Yeah. Visalia Venom.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
I mean, they've got it.
Are these all places
now we're doing minor league hockey teams?
Visalia Venom is the MMA gym that Tom is a hunchback
at. Actually, it's the Valencia Venom. I'm not fucking with you.
I know you're not.
Are there any Central Valley cities that got one?
I'd have to look again, but
I probably would have picked that.
I feel like they need one. I feel like it would be good for the community.
I feel like I saw Bakersfield floating around in there somewhere, but I could be wrong.
I was on the road, like, some
Bakersfield
for some reason.
Crew.
I think I had one of those nights where I had to like drive overnight from one show to get to the next town for whatever fucking reason.
Gotcha.
Probably just because I was whatever town I was in made me feel afraid. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but, Dave, you posted a picture one time. It was the fucking Vietnam gun to the head picture. But you're like the view from my hotel in Barstow, right?
It was needles, but yes.
Oh my god. Needles.
I remember I was on the road with Zach Peterson and we were driving overnight and we were like however the fuck we were in Alabama and however the fuck Google Maps took us, we were not on highways. And so we were just like driving through backwoods areas and it was dark as shit the whole time and we were like needed snacks and we pulled over at this gas station that was just a tiny little hut and one pump. And we're like, let's make this fucking quick, dude. And so we get in. There's a dude behind the counter and then one other dude in there who's like, man, one of the biggest people I've ever seen, fat-wise. Just like so huge, wearing overalls.
Oh, my
the
God.
The biggest overalls I've ever seen.
That were made for an SUV cover that he added straps.
Dude, that very specific way that people can look in the South. You don't see that type of...
Oh, yeah. It's a whole sub-genus.
Yeah,
you know?
Right. And you know, like, not to be a dick, we have our own pieces of shit here.
Oh,
but
yeah.
They're this very specific...
I saw a guy walking a parrot in Hollywood, taking his parrot for a stroller walk. So, yeah, that's bad, too.
Yeah, absolutely. But he's got that very specific, huge overalls, hiding a massive gut, big beard, camo everything, camo teeth, you know what I mean? Where are they?
Yeah. That's real good.
Thank you. And so he's looking, and he's also just got this real mean look on his face, and he's fucking like staring at us, and I'm like, oh, Jesus. And I'm looking for water and something that resembles, you know, snap peas or whatever fucking lame ass California shit I eat on the road. And then I'm like probably 5 feet from him, and he is looking at an entire like cooler of all the Mountain Dew flavors, and he's just staring at it after he's finished staring at me. He's just looking, and it's quiet. And then I ignore him for one moment, and out of nowhere I hear him go, oh, what the fuck? And I turn and look at him very scared, and he goes, Mountain Dew fucking lemonade. And he throws the thing open, pulls it out, and stares at it and is like, you gotta be fucking kidding me, man. And looks at me, grabs two of them, runs to the counter, pays them, and leaves.
Wow.
And then drives back to Johnson City.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Holy
shit. And that was
shit.
The owner of Mountain Dew.
Look at this.
That was Jeremiah Dew?
Yeah, it was Jerry. Yeah, totally.
Yeah, Johnson City Gold was the best one. So I think that's it for this segment.
Oh, man, that was do or don't. The Mean Boys Podcast will be right back with your questions, comments, and voicemails in the Mean Boys mailbag right after this, everybody.
What's going on?
Marcus? Marcus, is that you?
Yeah, it's me. What the fuck is going on?
I don't know. I'm strapped to a thing. My head's in some sort of vice.
Yeah, mine too.
I've never been in anything like this before.
Me neither. I don't remember anything leading up to this.
I remember being at the bar with your girlfriend, who is also African-American, and I was talking about the women's studies class I was thinking about taking, but then I realized it conflicted with my Frisbee Golf League.
Oh, yeah, I remember that now. I think I blacked that out before we got drugged.
African-Americaned it out.
No, that's not what that means, Jim.
Oh, man, this situation is really checking my privilege. I've never been anything like this before. I assume you've been in situations this bad before, considering your upbringing.
I grew up in West Hollywood, Jim. We never had torture devices strapped to our head in the mean streets of WeHo.
Wow, I'm learning so much about your culture.
Can we just focus on getting the fuck out of this trap so that we both don't die?
Marcus and Jim, you have both lived lives of luxury.
Well, I didn't say that. He said that. I didn't say that about you.
And now is the time to see if life is worth living with sacrifice. Marcus... You claim no one is there for you, and you cut your wrists. Now, if you wish for your friend to live, you must saw off your hand. A trap is rigged, and if your arm is not out of that device in 50 seconds, your friend's head will be crushed. Let's see if you can be there for another.
Fuck, fuck, fuck!
Jim, it's okay. I got you.
Fuck! Okay, I did it. I cut it off.
Jim, you are now safe. But if you want to save your friend, you must also make a sacrifice.
Oh, God.
Jim, you have 50 seconds. Say the N-word.
Well?
Yeah, I don't really feel comfortable saying that.
What? Dude, I have one hand. Just say it. You have my permission to say it.
No, that would be racist. I'm not a racist.
Oh, for God's sake, it's fine. Look, just say it with an A at the end.
No, it has to be with the hard R.
Whatever. Dude, if you don't say it, I will die. What do you not understand about this situation?
Hey, even Jigsaw won't say that word. I'm not going to say that word. This could be a trap.
It is a trap. It's a trap that has my entire fucking head stuck in a vice. Say the word.
No, I'm not comfortable with it.
Come on, just rap it out with me, buddy. It's okay if you rap it along with the song. Now, I ain't saying she's a gold digger.
Actually, the term gold digger is problematic, too, and I have a hard time enjoying the music of Kanye West now that he supports Donald Trump.
Man, fuck you and fuck Donald Trump. Say the N-word, motherfucker.
I'm trying to be an ally.
You're gonna kill me.
Marcus, I am not a racist. Marcus? Marcus? Well, at least I'm on the right side of history.
And now a clip from this week's Patreon bonus episode featuring Robbie Goodwin.
I know, Robbie wearing the same outfit as me.
Connor's pulling it off a lot better.
Also, it was hurting my feelings. I was like, look at this douchebag. Yeah, like, wait, that's exactly what I wear, a bomber jacket over a champion hoodie. What the fuck?
It does, if you picked Connor in a fighting game and then, the second guy also picked him, it would just come up as Robbie.
Oh, yes, exactly.
I'm a Smash Bros. Clone of
exactly.
Connor.
Yeah, you're the fucking light blue Pikachu.
Yeah, you're the green Kirby, my dude.
Mexican swap meet copyright infringement free version.
Hey, it's me, Pikachu.
Pikachu-y.
Yeah, Thunderbolt.
All right. Now Robbie's got a breath. He's got a
Yo soy el zap zap.
He's flexing on us by doing his East Coast racist accents because he's part of the Gas Digital podcast of the ball.
Yes, I came here to be very honorable.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Now,
Mean Boys is canceled.
We're behind the paywall. You can fucking turn L's into R's all you want over here.
Yeah, say you were selling loose cigarettes outside a gas station. What would you sound like? give us a ballpark.
Hello, sir. Nice to meet you.
Bitch.
Hello, I'm very African American.
Hello, yes. I'm one of those white black guys.
This is not very real ass at all. This is fake ass podcasting right here.
Fuck.
Oh, we're back in the trap. We got the mentally ill mongoose. We got the partylicious seagull.
Hack-a-mico.
Yeah. You are kind of like a seagull because you're fat, but you're also at the beach, but you're surprisingly spry. You know,
what a kind, hurtful thing.
Dude, I've seen you get a lot of French fries off the ground.
That was like a neg. I think Connor's trying to fuck you.
It really was. Hey, man, I thought one of the white black guys. It wasn't a neg.
I could have fucked Keith 9 years ago. I've only known him for six. You know what I'm saying?
One of our first bonding experiences was eating someone else's French fries together.
Oh yeah, we walked into a green room and then I was just like, so we're gonna steal these, right? And Keith's like, 100%.
Yeah, well, I walked into the green room and there was just these buffalo fries. It felt like Indiana Jones, like walking up to the idol or whatever, and I'm like, I can't be the guy who eats them even though they're not mine. And then Connor walks in wordlessly and just takes them.
Oh yeah, I was,
that's a great grift because Connor does not look like that guy.
No.
And you're leaning into it.
You have any idea how many times
you have the white friend to talk to the police? I'm the skinny guy that steals the food for the fat friend.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
That's my role.
But
I
feel
occupy.
Like if we got caught, you would have thrown me under the bus immediately.
I've never more excited to do anything in life than throw you under the bus.
Yeah. You know how many times you
I blame you for so many farts.
Oh, yeah.
I've
seen him blame me for farts that I know he did.
I've blamed him for a fart, and it's just because I took my shoes off.
You blamed me for farts when we were the only two people in the car.
Yeah, and you believed it, because you've got a lot of internalized fat shame.
Dude, you fucking gaslit my asshole.
Yes. I've heard of gaslighting, but this is ridiculous.
Hell yeah, dude. We're rolling.
The Mean Boys podcast is brought to you by Himalaya. Now, Himalaya is a brand new podcasting app, and I got to I've been using it to listen to all my podcasts throughout the week, and I love it. It's fucking great. It's very easy to use. It has a nice clean UI. You know, it's just you know, it's just a very workable. You pick it up and you right where everything is immediately.
Yeah,
you know?
I mean, of all the ways you can put podcasts in your ears, I think this is like one of the easiest ones around.
Guess who?
God damn it!
It's me. Mr. Ear, here to represent Himalaya.
I need everyone listening to understand how sad I was when I realized we had another auditory-based sponsor, and I couldn't kill Mr. Ear again.
A new podcasting app that you can listen to with your ears.
Yeah, I'm going
to
be honest with you. We planned this whole let's surprise everyone with Mr. Ear bit out, and I'm actually getting real-life annoyed now. So this has turned from let's get fun comedy piss to I want to fucking hit you because I hate
Mr. Ear doesn't believe in hitting, but he does believe in using great podcasting apps like Himalaya.
Just Himalaya.
Just
though.
Like the country. Yeah, just Himalaya.
Just the one that's sponsoring the show.
Head over to the App Store and download a risk territory. Why don't you? Hi, guys. Himalaya is a very cool app. Just go. There's a link for it in the show notes. Just browse around. And like I said, you can get complacent with shit in your life and just get used to something. And it's literally 45 seconds away from maybe you've just got a better fucking alternative. And like that's 10% easier than that, however much adds up to your day. So
I hear they have a tip jar.
I'd like to hear the sound of you hitting the bottom of a well.
I also hear that they have playlists.
Playlists.
That's a feature they're rolling out very soon where you can like make playlists of your different podcasts. So if you want to, you know, listen to all your other favorite David Ross podcast. I don't know what
David Ross. Please, David Ross, my father. Call me Vagina Ambassador.
Yeah, no, my dad called me Dave Ross, but I call him Fat. Yeah. Holy fuck.
Yeah, you can make playlists.
I'm realizing I have no idea. I can't do a good day. We got a similar voice. I should be good at it, but I got nothing.
You can make playlists of all your favorite shows. They do have a tip jar if you want to give your favorite creators some stuff. Maybe go over there. Give us a follow if you want to drop Dave a dollar in the tip jar, something like that.
Yeah, you know, go shake some stripper money at him, you know?
Yeah,
like that,
strippers.
Ross.
You don't hear them. You see them. But I hear on Himalaya podcast.
Shut the fuck
and
up.
This isn't like also this isn't like some new app that doesn't have like podcasts like any ones you listen to on it. It's like they have everything's just on it. Like what if you're looking for some whatever your friend's fucking podcast? It's on Himalaya.
Here's
they already
this
got
is a
it.
Powerful app. They got through enough good ones that they were like, I guess we'll let Mean Boys over too.
I know, that's funny. Yeah. Oh, geez. There goes the neighborhood. What's up, Rogan? it's a cool shit. Playlist, tip jar, easy UI. Just go give it a shot.
Wonderful interface.
Follow Mean Boys. Download Himalaya and please tweet Tom to do something bad to his body because of what he's done.
You know
here.
What's great about interfaces?
What?
Faces have ears.
That's barely true.
Whoa, that was next level.
Mr. Ear here telling you
stupidity.
To subscribe to Himalaya.
That,
up and away!
We're not fucking doing end of it. No more. Bye.
Quang!
The Mean Boys podcast returns, and it's time for your questions, comments, and voicemails. All that and more in the Mean Boys mailbag.
It's me.
That was our jingle. Henry Davis writes, any banana famas lately? That joke really has taken on a life of its own within the Mean Boys community.
Oh, yeah?
It's become a benchmark moment. It was in our best of show.
It's the only joke a guest has ever done when we're like, we might have to make merch of that joke.
we might have to cut Dave into something here and figure
it out.
Yeah,
you might get 10%
of touching my heart.
Yeah, banana famine, baby onesie. Cass Smiley asks, which band does Dave wish would commit suicide the most?
Oh, my God. I don't fucking know.
Johnson City Gold.
Nazi band, I want them to be like the Nazi version of like the Bay City Rollers. Like they're just like kind of like 70s.
They sound like Kiss.
Yeah, exactly.
Shauna, no white busing power. Into my district.
Gimme white power.
Oh, yeah.
The sound guy, you got that drop for future morning shows?
Yeah,
thank
can
you.
Can we use this to blackmail Dave? Great.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, in earnest, I guess what all Nazi bands would probably be
yeah,
my
that's
answer
the,
to that.
Yeah, we don't really want anyone to commit suicide.
No, that's the thing. I don't really want that.
Yeah, that's true. You know, but...
I don't think anybody took it. I guarantee you Dave Grohl is not going to listen and be like, did they say I should kill myself? What I'm saying is the Foo Fighters is the correct answer.
I think it's Incubus. The band that, like, oh. I really... There are some bands I get behind even ironically, and then also, like, man, the older I get, the more I'm finding that I actually like shit I thought I hated.
Oh, yes.
Like, I love... This is true. I fucking love Limp Bizkit.
Dude, so do I.
Dude, I love Limp Bizkit. The reason I hated Limp Bizkit was because of what they represented and what their fans were.
Yeah.
And now that that doesn't matter to me, I'm like, oh, I really like to listen to this.
Yeah.
And I always did.
What did they represent?
Well, douchebags.
I mean, come on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Name a band that isn't a douchebag.
No, but like a certain strain. I've been a Sublime fan since forever, so
yes.
I totally get it. Where I'm like, I don't hate you. I just hate everyone who likes you.
You're talking to the guy who has a detailed opinion on the new Smash Mouth albums. I mean, it's like, at a certain point, who cares? Have fun, live a life.
Yeah, like what you like. We're all going to die one day.
The tough dudes in my high school loved Limp Bizkit, and, you know, they played into it. They, like, you know, fucking backwards red hat, big dude who, like... lifts and talks about women like they're garbage.
Right.
And all these dudes in my high school were garbage and they felt validated.
Right.
That's why I hated it.
You know what's weird is, like, it's so funny, and I've talked to Keith about this, but, like, that brand of person, they never really fucked with me. They never really acknowledged me.
Yeah.
The people who were actively mean to me were the people who listened to the punk bands, the Green Days, the fucking all the shit.
My people.
Your people were so fucking horrible to me.
Sorry. It's a bad coalition, you know?
Yeah.
Those people aren't. Our kids fucking suck too, man.
Yeah.
The older I get, the more those are my least favorite people.
Yeah, they suck in a more insidious way.
Dude, I just remembered something that one of those guys said to me, the douchiest thing I've ever heard in my life. This guy literally, like, I had a woodshop class with him. We used to cut candy bars in half in the bandsaw. And this just, like, tells you how fucking dumb they are and, like, why not, they're not worth respect. And he goes, you know, Pulp Fiction, man, joint hit. That's not even a movie, dude. That's a film.
Wow. Jesus Christ.
And then he just farted out of his eyes and grew a beret.
Yeah.
That's he thought that.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Very good way to put it. All right, guys. Ethan D. Lawrence, our friend from across the pond, writes, would you rather have the power of super fast flight but only 3 feet off the ground, or for 13% of your body to be bulletproof and you'd get dealer's choice on where your body that is? You know, so you could say your heart or your, you know, stomach or whatever.
Wow.
It's kind of interesting.
I go with the super fast flight.
Yeah,
you know?
Same.
I do,
really,
too.
Because really, you're only 3 feet off the ground, whatever. That's really just running fast. Like,
yeah.
It's still pretty cool.
But I would still probably be peeing in water bottles if I could fly like that.
Yeah.
Like, I'm still late. I factored that into the lateness, and I just probably just like doing this for some.
I gotta be there in 6 nanoseconds. I only got 4. Like,
yeah,
you gotta get to Mean Boys.
I like that we have superpowers, but we still live here and do this bullshit.
Yeah,
that's a tough one, because the 13%, very helpful, I guess, but I think I would only need to protect the heart, because, like, I there's no point protecting my brain at this point.
Experiments, Tom.
Well, it's already bulletproof. When they tried to experiment, they, like, poked it with a metal stick, and the stick bent.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Here's the thing. Super fast flight, though, is like being 100% bulletproof.
Yeah,
well,
fly faster than bullets.
Yeah, but, like, do you guys drink? You might get drunk and then just start running into shit, you know?
Absolutely.
You're not used
to
being...
This does not seem bad.
Yeah.
Here's my thing with the bulletproof.
You hear about Tom got an FUI?
Oh, you know what I'm doing? I'm doing bulletproof, and I'm bulletproofing my genitals. That's the only
thing. What are you going to do with the other 12.5%?
Damn.
Come on.
Nice, dude.
Yes.
Wow.
Fuck yeah.
Tom, I hate to do it, but you just got...
High five me.
No.
Fucking piece of shit.
It was good.
Oh, God.
You're the vagina ambassador now.
Man, that's that Johnson City goal.
Other 12.5%
joke at everything. Numbers, tiny dicks, all my favorites.
Protect my butthole. Bulletproof butthole.
Yeah. No,
first man in the world.
Who's trying to shoot you in the butthole?
It's not about
who's
going to
shoot
butthole. It's not about who's going to shoot me. It's about being able
to say, about that.
Yeah. Hey, my ass is perfect. You want to see? Take a shot. And then they got to be like, oh, fuck. Metal ass.
Somebody, you do this. Somebody tried to shoot you in the asshole. Misses. Hits your spine. You are now paralyzed with
like
a bulletproof anus.
Tom is spending his 13% just really like, okay, so I got my butthole. I got my right nut because that's the one that makes the boy sperms. I got my nose, the left earlobe, and then the back of my neck because I just don't like to be touched there.
I'm just saying.
I love the idea that the thing you think makes an asshole perfect is that it's bulletproof.
I'm just saying.
Oh, man.
Like, you've ever seen a girl's asshole? Yeah. Like, look how fucking resilient
it is.
Oh,
my God.
I'm just saying, if
I don't eat ass because it's unsafe.
if you're in an argument.
Unsafe at any speed.
Yeah, no, if you're in an argument.
If you're in an argument, you're like, oh, that's tough. You went to Afghanistan or whatever. Shoot me in the butthole and then watch them lose their money. You will become the most powerful person in that bar.
You're just trying to become a bar bet millionaire where you just trick enough rednecks into shooting you in the asshole.
Also, I could make so much money off being in Jackass 97 or whatever fucking number they're on.
The number would be four.
You would make like a moderate amount of money doing that.
It's funny because all of this would be true if you could fly really fast and you wouldn't be a total dumbass.
The Jackass guys all have cameo accounts. They're not doing well.
Yeah,
right? They're selling their skateboard collections to pay for their child support.
I could be a part of Jackass and also have a bulletproof butthole. Like, it's not one or the other.
Hey, that would be funny.
Everyone's favorite person. And they're like, all hammered. Someone
shoot him in the butthole.
Get a crossbow with this bitch.
Bend him over. Spread his cheeks. You got to be sure.
Yeah, Tom, just go and turn that bar stool upside down. I want to show you something.
Oh, you think she got an ass? You can throw a grenade in mine. Nothing will happen.
It's bulletproof, not grenade proof.
Dude, the butthole will be fine. The cheeks will have a problem.
Meanwhile, we're all over here like, we can fly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'll go quickly to places I need to be. You're like, shut up, nerd. Yeah. Put rockets in me.
What a bunch of rubes we are.
Yeah. You got to your butt.
All right, guys. We got some fun voicemail. This one, I like that the people in England don't want to pay roaming charges, so they just send us a voicemail from their iPhone.
That's great. Know?
So this guy writes us, oi, oi, mean boys. I figured I'd send this in case your American listeners actually start assuming we, parenthetically the British, sound anything like you. Oh, and I know people always tell you how much you help them through all the really tough times in their life, so I just want to let you know that you guys really helped me get through working a stable job in a tech company. My life is great, but you guys make it just a little bit nicer. Oh, and I'd appreciate if you read this whole thing in a Cockney accent. Ta very much. Oh, sorry. Cheers, Clarence.
Oh, I'll figure out. I'd send this in case you American listeners.
Hard pass. Stop it at once.
Shoot him in the butt.
Let's shoot him anywhere but the butt.
Let's hear his voicemail here. I'm excited. All right, I'm pulling it up.
Oi!
Boys, I'm Clarence, and I thought like this, apparently.
Pudding.
Mate, listened to your episode about, shitty accents towards the end.
What is he saying?
Always fun. But Tom, you're not the only one who sounds like a stereotypical American. You got Connor, who sounds like a proper, like, surfer dude, bro. Like, totally radical, man.
Thanks, dude.
Well, actually, Keith sounds kind of cool. So,
ooh, okay. Wow. Good for
what do you say?
This gay guy sounds cool.
Anyway, when are you guys going to come to London? it'll be awesome. And
we'd love to, but...
hit me up, and I'll show you around.
We will, though.
Get you hammered. Be great.
I already got hammered in the bus.
Also, Keith, whatever happened to the Carnock screenplay? Because it was really, really good. I would definitely stream that online for free.
I also wrote fucking half of it.
Well, as the sole writer of Carnock the Blood Feast,
I'd love to watch it. So if you get on making that would be great.
Yeah, get on getting a television animated show greenlit.
Yeah, pause this for a second.
Fuck everything.
I do love how people think television works. They're like, why didn't you just make that show? Like, I don't. You wrote it and it was funny. So why is it not just what Comedy Central is now?
Everything that is funny gets made.
Yeah, we've had devious internal meetings. Me and Connor, we have plans to try and do something with this.
We didn't forget about it, but it's again we're trying to accumulate the requisite juice.
There's a lot of secret plans being hatched and fucking shit brewing in
Mean Boys.
Mean Boys writing stuff world, so stay tuned.
So
if you get on making that would be great.
I want to hear the fuck everything God is dead.
I know all your fans would appreciate it. So, fuck everything God is dead.
Oh, I love it. It's,
it's so gentle.
I know. It's like it's so cool that people say that, and that guy's fucking 2,000 miles away. It still blows my mind. Thanks,
buddy. I love that they think I sound like a stereotypical American, because in America, they don't know what the fuck I'm talking like.
You sound like you're from Jersey.
I have. So my godparents are from Brooklyn.
Okay.
And then my mom's from Chicago.
Yeah, and my dad was a media that hit my mom.
And I've had 12 concussions.
Where did you? If you've had more than 5 concussions, you definitely sound like you're from Jersey.
Yeah.
Where did you grow up? Here?
All around the Southwest, okay. Riverside, Orange County, Las Vegas, Visalia, Tulare,
Area 53,
San Diego.
Everywhere shitty enough for us to headline is where Tom
lived. Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much.
Yeah, Tom.
I didn't realize you lived in the Central Valley. That's
Tom
cool.
worked yeah. at you. Tom has lived at everywhere. Where if you were on True TV, you can make $150. Yeah. All right, we got another voicemail here. Let's see what this gentleman has to say.
Renee, live in New York. I do a lot of like shitty delivery.
Are you sure you didn't give this guy your free phone?
Like, before you start making big bucks on Patreon. And I don't know. Just want to let you know, when I'm out here fucking doing these shitty ass fucking drives all day long, you guys fucking keep me company. I'm a veteran. Got a little touch of the PTSDs. I live in a very small little bubble in my head, you know, what I find funny, and you guys fucking crack me the fuck up all day, every day. I just want to say thanks for doing what you guys are doing. Keep it up. Oh,
yeah, that was
the
shit.
Yeah, so the greatest voicemail of all time.
That was really beautiful, and I also I want you to know that I'm 100% writing the podcast off as charity work on my taxes because of this. Hey, Uncle Sam, I've done more for them than you have in a long time. I know.
It's kind of chappy that you're like, well, my friends died, but they died protecting freedom, and then we're like, what if farts were boners?
Now, if your ass could be a butler, what would you name it? I'll start Peeves because of poop and Jeeves. I think it's good.
No, thank you, man. And I met you at Skankfest. I met you a couple times. Every time I'm at New York, you're a super cool dude.
I don't know. Did I meet you?
I think you did. But yeah, we'll see you next time we're out in New York, man.
Yeah, that means a lot, dude. And have fun selling those drugs to other people with PTSD and just keeping the cycle continuing, because that's how we build a new listenership.
Yeah.
Honestly.
If you guys get better.
Yeah, if you guys get better, real bad for our bottom line. I'm kidding. I love you very much.
Yeah, that voicemail meant a lot, actually.
Yeah, that was fucking beautiful.
So I found Mean Boys. So I found myself on a plane, and the pilot was an Australian. And I found out that I am immediately cautious and disturbed by the fact that my pilot was an Australian. All right, see you, faggot. Good luck making fun of me.
And then a pretty abrupt tone shift.
Man, yeah. I love that we followed the PTSD one with, hey, you guys are fags. I have an Australian pilot. Later, nerds.
All right. Well, look, you sound too dirty, so I don't think you're gay, so I'm going to have to say go fuck yourself.
Yeah, dude.
Jesus.
I think we are. I mean, yeah. I'm not going to get on my soapbox for too long, but we're done throwing that fucking word around, right?
The fuck, Australians are naughty words.
No, I hate Australians, especially gay ones.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they have sex with the left side of the butt down there. It's crazy.
Nice, dude. Nice.
Hell yeah.
Bulletproof.
Bulletproof.
See, this sex spins counterclockwise.
This does worry me that I feel like there's a large group of people that are like, oh, that's the podcast that's just all about white on white racism and casual gay bashing.
Yeah, no, dude.
Eat shit, stop listening.
Yeah.
He might be. Yeah,
he might just be. A lot of times people just don't really.
Haven't called in a while. What soup would be the best lube? Thanks.
You see, that's what we're looking for.
It is.
What soup would be the best lube?
Bullets.
Tomato bisque seems pretty good.
Oh, yeah, because it's all thick. Yeah.
But then again, broth, seems kind of oily.
Well, I feel like you don't
want... a chowder.
Yeah.
I think a chowder.
Because tomato, you're...
What about the chunks? Is it like a chunkless chowder?
Well, you take the chunks out.
Yeah.
Yeah, you strain it. I'm just asking.
Yeah.
No need to jump down my throat.
Hey, you take the chunks out, you fucking idiot.
All right, you know what? Why don't you take a flight with an Australian, Dave? I'll tell you that. To the moon!
Bam, pow! No, yeah, I think it's chowder.
Gotta be chowder.
Yeah, because a tomato, you don't want citric acid by your pee hole. That seems like it's going to be bad.
I like how you developed a Boston accent. You don't want citric acid in your freaking pee hole over there. What are you doing? You're gonna iodize your ball sack doing that?
Oh, hey.
I think you gotta go with like an udon, because that's the most noticeable soup. Just like there's noodles everywhere, you get that slithering and shit.
So your choice of lube is noodles.
Noodles.
Wow. Tom. It's the Gatorade of answers.
he's wrapping them around spiral style, trying to make like a noodle condom. And he's like, if I knot it at the end, it'll be like a wicker basket.
You crocheted yourself a fuck spaghetti.
While you're fucking from behind, you just like smack that ass with a nude on, and then that creates like,
some sort of pasta based BDSM.
Yeah, yeah.
Bondage domination spaghetti meatballs.
Just woo, noodle snap, you know?
Man, I'm so glad I'll never fuck you.
What sort of Taiwanese little bee song awful. Are you describing?
If I gotta choose a soup, you might. Dude, why go 0.5%?
Wait.
What are you talking about?
0.5%? What does your bulletproof ratio have to do with this?
Why
just
not
trying
though?
To think of what would lube you up.
No, fuck that.
That's all.
Fuck that. Fuck that with a rubber dick. If I gotta fuck with soup,
uh-huh.
I'm gonna make it as soupy and as weird as possible. I'm not gonna just chowder would be nice.
Oh, man,
no,
I am
fuck
now
that.
Also
I'm
glad
I'm,
I'll never fuck you.
I'm gonna we're, Tom, someone's you? Gonna gag me with menudo, and then we're gonna do it doggy style.
Wait,
I want
that someone is you when you're high and you have $9 at 1 a.m. That's
man, well, that flew off the rails.
Yeah, don't half-ass that soup, fucking. You got to go all out with the chowder.
I think we're, do we have any more?
Yeah, we got one more. Should we do another one? Should
all
we call
out
it?
With
let's
the
wrap
chowder.
It up. We'll save another one for next time.
All right, yeah. Well, I think that's just about the whole show. Dave, thanks for coming back.
Dude,
buddy.
I love you guys.
Yeah,
thanks for having
you're
me.
You're recording your album at the Echo in L.A.
Yes,
tell people
February
where
to go. 12th.
You got to go to that. Dave's one of the most fucking funniest comedians working right now. It's a treat to watch him. Go be a part of history, King.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to go to that.
Fuck yeah. Yeah. And I'll see you guys there.
Yeah, man. And
I can't think of any other album recordings going on.
Yeah, if you're still listening, be a part of shittier history and come to my album recording January 27th at the Chatterbox in West Covina.
Dude, yeah. January 27th. I didn't know that.
Yeah, next Sunday.
Fuck, man. I'm not going to be here.
I would love to be there. I will rebook the show. So
Dave,
awkwardly feel compelled to show up
February
and then be like.
February 12th would be brilliant.
Don't worry.
All right, cool. Dave. Tell you. Yeah, fuck everything.
I got a special surprise. I've been working with the tech team. We're Skyping you in.
Yes.
I got a whole crew. It was pretty expensive, but I thought you should be there.
We're going to use that hologram Tupac technology to just broadcast you ordering a vodka and not paying attention.
Yeah, and hey, guys, everybody's doing stuff. I got some exciting Reno-related announcements I'll be making in the coming weeks. Tom, you got anything to plug? Oh, and of course, you got to listen to Suicide Buddies with Dave and Hampton over on Label Mates with us over here on Starburns Audio. Over in the cool kids
Give
table.
Us a spin.
Yeah, just fucking sneaking cigs, you know, drawing Volcom stones on all of our sneakers. It's going to fucking rock.
Oh, I know. I know what I want to fucking announce. March. Wait, is it. Which month is 3? March, right?
This is amazing.
March is 3. I was mixed up March and May. March is 3, May
is 5. I actually
5.
Think that's got to be the whole announcement.
I now know which month is 3. That is my proclamation.
March 14th through 17th, I will be at the Yukon Comedy Festival in Yukon, Canada.
You couldn't remember which month was 3 and you were expected to do international travel unaccompanied.
Yep. I will be going to Canada for the Yukon Comedy Festival. There's a lot of really other great comedians on it. I'm really excited to do it.
Oh, my God.
It's the three.
Oh,
it's the three. It is in March. Not May,
God.
March.
I'm sorry.
Not April. Not March as fuck. And it's gonna be cold. It's gonna be hot. Hot comedy in March 14th through 17th. Come on,
cool.
And, I'm gonna do some weird shit, man.
I love it so much, dude. Yeah, I'm going through the Yukon on which one is 3?
Yeah, on February 46th.
I'm crying.
Oh man,
I'm crying.
Holy shit!
Does Halloween happen once a year?
But I am genuinely excited for that.
No, it's going to be a
blast. I got to get a passport.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess they drink a toe out there or something.
They
and
what?
I'm excited about that.
They have a drink with like an old frozen toe, like a human toe, and you like pay to drink it, but you have to like make sure the toe touches your mouth.
Oh.
It's a weird. It's like one of those things you do to say you did it.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then when do you get the teddy bear? Like when
there's some sort of reward.
Yeah, and I also think they have discount cuz Yukon is there's a lot of other Canadian listeners. If any of you are interested, I think they have discount flights or something like that, but I don't really know about
about that.
Yeah.
But yeah, you should, you had enough trouble with the month.
Yeah.
Not to mention the Expedia.
Just if you live within driving distance, I'd love to meet the Canadian fans.
Yeah, go out there and see Tom. Tom's in rare form. He's been
the Yukon.
It's like, I think it's like the North Dakota of Canada, where it's just like there's nothing there. But it's north. Uh-huh. It's like, I guess it's going to be like fucking very snowy and cold.
Okay. Yeah, I almost got real condescending. I was like, well, you know, north, that's how Canada works. There's no Canada by Mexico.
There's also north of Canada. There's, you know.
Yeah.
It just keeps going.
Yes. Santa's house.
Yeah. that's the 5 month I'll be doing a festival in the, yeah.
Yeah. I'm doing a corporate for the elves.
Yeah, I'm doing ElfCon.
Which one is up?
Okay, I'm in month number three, the 14th day, I'm going to Upland.
Excuse me, Navigator, can you send me to the top of the planet?
Was that my worst plug? No. Was it the most memorable? Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. Well, that's the show. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Dave.
Thank you. Thanks for having me, guys.
Fucking a favorite, man. I'm glad you came back.
Right. Thanks, dude.
Fuck everything. God is dead. Oh, shit.